In this video, we're going to discuss a scheme called check kiting. So check kiting involves floating funds between your bank accounts using checks to inflate your cash balance. And the reason that a company or a person might do this is you need money today and you don't have money. So it's a way of accessing short-term credit. Or if you're trying to fool your auditor into thinking that your company has more cash than you actually have on hand. So let me show you how this works. So let's say that your company has two different bank accounts. They've got an account with Bank of America that has $1,000 in it, and then they've got an account with Wells Fargo that has $0 in it. Now, one thing the company could do is they could write a check off of the Bank of America account and then deposit it in the Wells Fargo account. So let's say they wrote a check from the Bank of America account for $8,000, and then they turned around and deposited it in their Wells Fargo account. So then the Wells Fargo account is now going to go to $8,000 today, right? You just made a deposit. Now you might be thinking, well, you only have $1,000 in the Bank of America account. Well, the company that or person who's committing this fraud is hoping that, okay, well, Bank of America isn't going to immediately know about that. They're not going to know. It's going to take some time before the check clears, okay, and actually is paid out of the Bank of America account. And so that person, that fraudster, is basically taking advantage of the time it takes for a check written off of this account to clear, okay? So they write that check. They have insufficient funds here to pay the $8,000. And so now they've got the $8,000 in the Wells Fargo account. And maybe they say, well, okay, I'm going to take out, you know, Wells Fargo might not allow them to take out the entire $8,000. So maybe they take out $7,000. So they say, okay, now I'm going to take out $7,000 out of this. So now this is down to $1,000. And they get $7,000 cash today that they didn't have. And so maybe the company was on the verge of bankruptcy and they turned to this scheme to try and pay off one of their creditors. And then they're hoping that they can somehow come up with this money because they wrote this check off of this Bank of America account. Well, Bank of America, they've only got $1,000. And they're going to need to eventually, it's going to catch up with them, and they're going to need $8,000 when this check clears. So what they're hoping is maybe they can come up with somehow, after they use the $7,000 for whatever they need, that they can somehow get another $7,000 and put it back in here before the bank finds out. Okay, so it's a desperate thing. It's definitely illegal. Another thing that people might try and do with it, if you're saying, okay, well, I don't even want the cash. I just want to, I've got an auditor coming today and I have overstated my cash balance and I want the auditor to think that I have more cash than whatever I have. So then you write this $8,000 check from B of A. And so now you've got the $8,000 in Wells Fargo and maybe you don't withdraw. You don't withdraw any of the money. You just say, okay, to the auditor, hey, look, I have $9,000 in my accounts. Remember I told you I had $9,000 cash? Well, see, here I do. I have that money. So not always are they trying to get access to short-term credit. It might be they're trying to just trick somebody to thinking that they have more cash than they had. Now, I give a simple example with two accounts, but there are people who set up 20, 25 different bank accounts and really get sophisticated schemes going. Now, check kiting. So basically, due to advances in technology, and by that I mean shortening the time it takes for a check to clear because of electronic processing of checks, that has really reduced the incidence of check kiting because checks can clear much, much faster than they did in times past. Also in the United States, in 2004, we had this check clearing for the 21st Century Act. That also sped up electronic processing of checks and changed the system. So this, and not to say this never happens anymore, but it's just, you know, not quite as prevalent. But it is something that an auditor should be aware of.